everyone. A very good morning to all of you students. Welcome to the session of the subject Building Construction Technology. So students, as you know that till now we have been discussing about the deep foundation, correct? Now in the deep foundation we discussed about the pile foundation, we discussed about the caissons. Okay, so now we are done with the module regarding the foundation. Now we are moving forward to the next module, to the next concept, that is known as masonry construction. Now what is masonry construction? If I ask you what comes to your mind, then you would be thinking that any kind of construction, right? Any kind of construction that takes place around you, let it be a wall or it be a foundation or a retaining structure or a high story building or a small bungalow or a tenement or a row house, right? Anything. So if I ask you that what is a masonry construction, the first thing that comes to your mind is that any kind of construction. But to be more precise, if I say if I have constructed a wall which is constructed using different building units, using different building blocks. Now, what are these building units? What are these building blocks? These blocks are made up of different material. In general sense, you have always seen that a wall is generally constructed of bricks, right? But in market currently, you can also see that white colored bricks are available and they are very much commonly used these days in the construction sites. Now, what are these building units? What are these blocks? So they are actually made up of fly ash and lime with mud mortar and different combination, but the basic constituent over there is fly ash. Why? Because as compared to your standard traditional bricks, these fly ash blocks will have less water absorption, they will be lighter in weight, they will be cheaper in cost. So because of all these different advantages which have overcome the traditional bricks, these fly ash bricks are being currently used in the market. So now let me come to the point that what is a masonry construction. It means when you are constructing a wall, let me just talk about only a wall, then we will move forward to the structural members like beams and columns, slab, foundation, right? All of those things are your structural members. But here if a wall is constructed, right, using a basic building unit, which may be a brick unit, which may be concrete unit, it may be timber. So using any kind of building block, when you are constructing a wall, then that kind of construction is known as masonry construction. Now if it is constructed using stones, then it is stone masonry. If it is constructed using bricks, then it is brick masonry. So likewise, whatever building unit you are going to use, whatever block you are going to use, based on that it is known as different type of masonry construction, out of which we are going to study about the stone masonry, brick masonry, composite masonry, which will have some miscellaneous type of combination of different material. Then we also have special type of masonry construction, so we shall discuss all of them step by step. So now what comes over here is that we have, in general, we have different types of walls called masonry walls, which we discussed right now. Then we have load bearing walls, and then we have non-load bearing walls, and we have retaining walls. Okay, so all of these types of constructions are masonry construction, but the walls, according to the load transfer mechanism, they will be divided into different categories. Now let us start with the first. See, directly we will not move to the masonry construction, but to move to the masonry construction, we first require certain technical terms to be discussed. See, now I am flashing all the technical terms together over here along with the cross-sectional sketch that you can see. I think you have studied this in building components also in your subject building planning. If you have studied about that, then this cross section of a building is generally comes in your basics of civil engineering also. So let us start with the basic building components. Here we have taken a cross-sectional sketch, cross-sectional elevation, starting from foundation to the wall up to the parapet level, right? We are taking a certain cross-section of a standard structure, and let us discuss about the main building components. Okay, so what do we have over here? The first we have is foundation. Now we are done with the foundation already. We discussed detailed information about the foundation. So the foundation is the substructure which is located below the soil. It means that below the ground level surrounding the subsoil, that is your foundation. It is utmost important component because it transfers the load and it keeps your structure stable. Second we have is basement. What is a basement? Basement is generally provided below the ground level, right? For what purpose? For generally for parking purposes, right? We also discussed that there are lots of special structures to be constructed, out of which one is a diaphragm wall. So that diaphragm wall is nothing but they are going to serve the purpose of the basement wall. So below the ground level, the stories which are provided is your basement. Next we have is plinth. You know that just exactly above the ground level comes your plinth level, then comes your lintel level. What is lintel level? The level where your openings, what are the openings? Means doors and windows. Again, they both of them will become components, right? Doors and windows will become component. So where your vertical openings are over, the level at which it gets over, that is your lintel level. And the level at which your windows start, your vertical opening starts, that is your sill level. So we have plinth level, we have sill level, and we have lintel level, right? Generally it is provided across the openings of your structure. It means the doors and the windows. Next we have is floor. You know why floor is important? Because a flat surface is required for you to dwell, for you to live. So that is your floor. Different types of flooring will be studied in detail later on. Next we have is DPC, that is damp proof course, which is provided just above the plinth level for the damp proofing of your ground floor. Next we have doors and windows. I think you are familiar with that. Lintel and sill, I told you, I discussed already. A masonry wall, in the cross sectional image you can see a wall is constructed using bricks. So that is your masonry wall, about which that particular construction we are going to talk about in this module. Then we have the roof and the parapet. The parapet wall is generally around 1 to 1.5 meter. It has to be provided for the safety purpose also. And we have the roof, that is your terrace. Okay, so these are the basic building components which you have studied till now. But now we will be moving forward with precisely the technical terms related to your masonry construction. Let us first start with the bricks. Okay, now take a single brick. Now if you observe that brick, then you would have seen that on top certain names are inscribed on it. Have you seen that? Okay, so look at the very first image flashing over here. Can you see a depression is provided at center, an indentation is provided at the center? See, I am using the technical words over here, students. We will call it as a depression, we will call it as indentation. Okay, it means it is nothing but the company or the initials which is inscribed on the surface, right? So let us technically define it, that what is it and why is it provided. So the depression or the indentation provided on the surface of the brick is known as frog. Now this frog is going to act as lock and key. So whenever you are providing mortar between the bricks, this indentation is going to help you bind them together. So that particular inscribed indentation is known as frog. Second definition, take a brick. Now suppose if this is your brick, then this is your length face, this is your width face. Now this length face, we will call it as stretcher. Can you see in the image? Yes, we can see that. So the length part, the length of the brick is known as stretcher face, and the width of the brick is known as header face. So we have three definitions. We have frog, we have stretcher, and we have header. Next, Now, if you want to cut bricks in particular manner, when is this required? If you are providing a corner brick or if you are providing certain kind of bonds in brick masonry, then there will be conditions where sometimes full brick is not going to accommodate. So for those cases, we will have to define certain cutting part, cutting portion for the brick. So let us talk about those technical terms. So the move to the second image. First of all, you can see over here is a full brick. Second, now in the second, if this is your brick, you are cutting it across its full length. You are cutting it half. You are cutting it half across its full length. Then that half brick will become your queen closer. It is known as queen closer. Next, you are going to cut certain portion from the corner such that half width is cut and half length is cut. So that particular corner portion which you are cutting is also a queen closer, but it is a quarter queen closer. If you cut it fully across the length, it is queen closer. If you cut just half portion from the corner, then it is your queen closer, but quarter queen closer. Okay, next what you are doing is you are going to cut the brick. You are going to cut the brick from the corner at an angle of around 45 degrees, such that half length is cut and half width is cut. That corner portion is chopped off, then this type of brick becomes your king closer. I'll give you one more example. If you just cut your brick from the center across its width into half, then it becomes your half brick bat. Okay, next what do we have beveled closer. So how you are going to cut it from the corner? Your width is going to get cut half, but your length is going to get cut fully. Then it becomes your beveled closer. Next, do the reverse thing. You are going to cut it from the corner. The width is fully cut, right? But the length is cut 3/4. Then it is known as mitrade closer. Okay, students, moving forward to the next type of technical terms. Next, I am taking a full brick masonry construction, and let us talk about how different type of technical terms have to be derived. So let us talk about the image. Look at the image flashing just right in front of you. I am going to teach from that directly. So first you can see that something like coin bricks is written. Coin bricks. Okay, so the cornermost brick for any brick construction, for any masonry wall construction. Suppose I am making the first horizontal layer, then I will make the second horizontal layer, then I will make the third one. Likewise, your masonry wall will be constructed. So first definition, if I construct a single horizontal layer, it is known as course, right? The one which you can see in front of your eyes will be your facing. The one which will be at backward side will be your backing. The one which will be provided at center, in case of more than 2 brick thickness or 1.5 brick thickness, then your center portion inside will be known as hearting. So I discussed about 4 definitions: course, facing, backing and hearting. Now about the coin. So whenever you want to start a course, you will have to provide a corner brick. It may be king closer, it may be queen closer, it may be half brick bed. So the cornermost brick is called coin. It is known as coin. It can be coin header, it can be coin stretcher, whichever face is appearing to you. Next we have is courses, which we already discussed. After that, the bricks will be bonded with the help of which material? With the help of mortar, right? It will be mixture of mud, sand and cement. And lime sometimes. So it is your mortar, that is your binding material. Then you will have vertical joints between the two bricks. Those are your joints. Okay, next what do we have? Heading course and stretching course. See, if you are making a course such that all of the bricks are laid with its length parallel to the facing, right, then it is known as which course? Stretcher course. And if you are placing the brick such that its length is perpendicular to the facing, then you will see the header portion, then that course will be known as header course. Did you understand, students? I think we are done with all of the technical terms. Next, we are moving with the vertical openings of the structure. About the structure, vertical opening means the door and the window. Let us talk about the window. So here, as I told you, that the point where your window starts above the floor level, that is your sill level. You have to provide a slab over there, right? That slab is going to support your window, support your opening. It does not fail. That is your sill level. Next, the vertical part of your window or your door is known as jambs. And the vertical part which is exposed to the atmosphere, which you can also see in the image over here, is known as reveals. So we have sill, we have jambs, we have reveal. Also we have lintel, which is provided at the top part, top level above the opening, that is your lintel. Okay, now moving to the next technical terms. Next, what do we have? We have coping, throating and weathering. Now, look at the image flashing over here. It is made up of brick, right? This can be made up of stone. This can be made up of concrete also. Whatever masonry construction you have. So, what happens over here is, if you have provided a sloped roof, then the provision of slope is known as weathering. Now, the structural member which is made, the sloping structural member which is made, is known as coping. And you can see underneath the coping, a groove cut is provided. What is the purpose of this groove cut? Whenever rain water comes on this surface, it is going to pass it, and it will not come directly in the contact with the wall. That is why a groove cut is provided. That is known as throating. Next we have is corbel. Now, you would have seen this in most cases for the stone masonry construction. In the stone masonry construction, at the corner, such a projected structural member is provided for the support, for the stability. That is known as corbels. Okay, students, so I think we are done with most of the technical terms, but I still suggest you to go through all of the different types of technical terms, which are even more, still more terms will be existing. Okay, so in this particular chapter, we are going to discuss about these many technical terms, concepts which you can see over here. What do we have? We have brick masonry, we have stone masonry, we have composite masonry, then we have lintel and arches, and then we have wall finishes. So these many concepts are going to be discussed in detail in this particular module. You can see for yourself with the images. I think you would have picturized in your mind also that what is stone masonry, what is brick masonry. About composite, whenever you are combining two different materials, that is your composite. About the lintel, I told you that it is across the opening, vertical opening of the structure. Arch is a curved shape which is also again provided across the openings. Okay, and last we have is wall finishes, that will be your plastering and painting works. So these many concepts will be discussed in detail. Okay, students, so that's it for the session. Now go through all the technical terms thoroughly, and then I suppose that you will be learning all of them and then attending the next lecture, so that it will be helpful for you to understand. Okay, students, have a good day. Thank you.